Building a legacy. Those words never spoke any clearer than when you are describing the newest inductees to the Liberty Club Sports Hall of Fame, as the members of the 2021 class were all builders for their respective programs. The first inductee was Beth Frackleton. Frackleton was the founder of both the men's and women's triathlon team, and shortly after founding the team, she would soon turn, at the time one of club sports' newest teams, into one of its most competitive, as the program would gain attention at the regional and national level. As a level 1 certified coach, she guided the programs to a second place finish for the men and a third place finish for the women in the Mid-Atlantic Conference team standings in 2012. That same year, the men's team would also finish that season ranked in the top 20 of the nation, which would only be the start to the strong nationally ranked program as the Flames are still today.
Wow, what an honor to be inducted with the two fellow gentlemen from today. It's an honor. It's an honor to be able to hopefully have set the stage for much greater successes moving forward.
The second inductee was Aaron Thompson. Thompson, a recruit from Vinton, Virginia, would join the Flames as an NCAA recruit. But when the Flames reclassified from the NCAA to the NCWA as a club program, Thompson would stay on and help Coach Castro move into the new division, a move that would usher in the program's success as he would become Liberty's second individual NCAA national champion at the weight class of 197 in 2012. He would also finish runner-up in 2013 and fourth in 2014, becoming the program's first ever three-time All-American, as the former Teague captain also helped the Flames ranked in the top four of the nation in all three seasons he competed at the NCAA. Leading the way for the Flames program being the number one NCAA wrestling program over four of the last six seasons.
This was awesome. It was a huge pleasure, and it's, again, like I said, a great thing to be inducted alongside the individuals today, coaches such as Beth and Will. It's good to see everybody, familiar faces. I'm very thankful to club sports for all that they've been able to do and they've provided for me and in my life.
The final inductee was Will Sharon. Sharon helped open Liberty Mound Snowflex Center in 2009, inviting a world of opportunities for him as the program's first head coach and Snowflex operations manager. He was instrumental in bringing the Snowflex games to Liberty from 2010 to 2015, and he also helped lead the ski and snowboard team to their first of many appearances at the USCSA National Championships, where the program would have its first individual podium finisher, as well as place a team high fourth in the nation in 2012, which then led the Flames to consistently being a top five national ski and snow program even till this day.
Well, it's just so special just to kind of, one, just get to know them a little bit more personally, meeting them finally after kind of coordinating for the last couple months with them, just some of the logistics, whether it's travel or getting here in the event. So hearing stories about their, accomplishments, but also just their character and personalities are just cool to kind of get to know them and meet all those inductees and kind of see what they were able to do and build the club sports programs and teams, and leave them in a better spot, than whenever they came into school.